Hey, what's up? Because a bunch of people asked how to activate the AI dummies in the firing range, I thought I would go through just a bunch of tips and tricks I have about the firing range that can make the time you spend in the firing range more efficient and more fun. Alright, let's go. Because it also happens in one of those entrances, I thought I'll show you how to activate the AI dummies first. For this, you go into this last entrance on the right side, switch to Pathfinder, swing up here. You might have to increase your brightness to see this, but there is a platform up here. Remove your entire inventory, walk up to here, look down, and switch legends. The sound you just heard confirms that you activated the dummies. If you are coming down here, I strongly suggest to immediately grab this gold shield here, else you'll be dead to them immediately and have to respawn. While we are at getting killed by the dummies, I can show you trick number two that I use very often. Instead of healing, you can just switch legends to immediately recharge your shield. If you get used to this a bit, you can switch legends to another legend and then back to the legend you actually were playing to immediately recharge your health and shield. Doing the same maneuver again, you can switch between active and still standing dummies. While we are at switching back and forth legends, this also recharges your ability. This resets your ultimate, but for example for training grapple slingshotting, this is really helpful. Where switching legends back and forth to recharge your health and shield becomes really interesting is with 1v1s, because you can not only enjoy the firing range by yourself, but with your normal trio squad or with as a duo. When doing a 1v1, be sure to pick up a self-revive shield. Using that, you can just toggle off friendly fire after you downed your partner, and using a golden backpack, revive them without them having to respawn and get their complete loadout back. If you don't want to do 1v1s to see who's the better of you, but just use it as sparring practice to improve your gunfight skills, I can highly recommend getting into the rhythm of immediately switching back and forth legends as soon as your shield is cracked, as you can see Crispy and me doing here. This is a fantastic way to rapidly increase your gunfight skills while also flushing out the adrenaline you usually feel during those. Of course, using an Evo shield for this is highly recommended. Another great way to improve your gunfight skills is to swing over here. And then swing up here. And walk into this corner and look right at this rock. And then switch legends again. Again, have an empty inventory for this. And you see that you have switched into third person mode. This is great to improve your gunfight skills because it clearly shows you your animations and what your hitbox is doing. Especially to be aware of what AD strafing does and crouch spamming, this really helps. But of course it's also just fun to have this perspective available to you. While we are at things that make the firing range mainly just more fun, there are targets back here and back there. Another mainly just fun thing is that you can catapult yourself with these targets. You have to stand on top of them and be on the back side of them. It doesn't work if you can see the front of them. And then just shoot them. If you are in the firing range to do something with usables, be sure to use a golden body shield. even when using Ultimate Accelerants, this still makes it faster. Speaking of ultimates you place with one legend will still remain if you switch legends. But certain abilities you place with one legend will disappear when you switch legends. Others, on the other hand, will stay. If I now use this placed zipline, I can show you the Nessies that are scattered around here. Most of you are probably aware of them, but all around the firing range are little Nessies hidden. I'm not sure where, but there are a bunch of spots you can get to where Nessies are placed. With that, I hope you can use some of these tips and tricks and they are helpful to you. If you want to see how I train recoil control in the firing range, I already have a video about this that I will link in the description. Thank you so much for watching, consider subscribing, and I hope you have a great day. Bye!